I would like to show you in this video how easy it is to calibrate an HBM sling scale, the SLS, in a lifter. Here you see the lifter and sling scale already assembled. Normally a sitting sling would be mounted on this lifter to hold the patient. Now, for purposes of calibration, I have replaced the sitting sling with a sturdy box where I will place weights later. The only additional items you will need are a coin and a slightly modified paper clip, which you should bend open. It will also be helpful to become acquainted with the operating instructions, which contain a detailed explanation with all the steps to follow for calibration. Now I will use the coin to unscrew the side cap of the sling scale. You can see the hidden button which has to be pressed to make the setting. We can also see the parameters that have to be set on the back of the scale. Now I press both buttons, the hidden one and the key on the front, and I see the maximum capacity of the scale is preset to 320 kilograms. The next key I press takes us to the settings menu for the increment, where I can select between a resolution of 100G, 200G, or 500G. I confirm 100G. The next key I press takes me to the range setting of the scale, a one range or two range scale. In this case, I see that I'm working with a two range scale, and that the changeover point is at 200 kilograms. I confirm the changeover point, and by pressing the hidden key again, it takes me back to the normal weighing range. Now I press the hidden button to go to the Setup Parameters menu, and the first query criterion is tenfold resolution, the setting of the resolution in the display, one or two places after the decimal. I can either turn it on or off. Zero is turned off and one is turned on. I set one in this case. The next query item for calibration in a partial load range is legal for trade. Am I in a legal for trade or not legal for trade mode of the scale? The sling scale permits three selection criteria. 0 for not turned on, 1 for OIML, and 2 for NTEP, which indicates legal for trade capability in the USA. I select 1 for OIML and confirm with the GN key. The gravitational acceleration factor, GC, which acts on the scale during calibration with weights, can be displayed or changed. Currently the display shows 9.81029, which is the G factor in Darmstadt, Germany. I can either confirm or overwrite this factor. To confirm it, I have to press the on-off key again so that the leading 9.0 disappears. Then I confirm the value. While I'm calibrating the scale, I can decide whether I want to calibrate with a full load or partial load. In this case, I have only 200 kilogram weights on hand, so I should tell the scale I would like to calibrate with true weights of 200 kilograms for a maximum capacity of 320 kilograms. I can press the GN key to activate the different digits and then change a flashing digit that is activated with the on-off key. And now I set the test weight for calibration to 200 kilograms for the first weight I have now. When I confirm the test weight of 200 kilograms, the scale automatically assumes its zero value, and I can then add weights to move the test weight up to 200 kilograms. After the last weight is placed in the box, 200 kilograms appears in the scale display. I confirm and end the process with the GN key.